back here for some bonus coverage at Mira Mesa, as both subdivisions couldn't bowl until after the title matches are over, and we are still fully loaded with Abagañas. Caitlin on the left playing Madison Holman for the girls' title, while Elias is going to once again try to defeat an Abagaña, this time playing Josh for the U17 title. Elias the runner-up from Caitlin in main scratch. Caitlin beat Josh in the main scratch semifinals on her way to the win. Madison qualified second earlier today, so she was actually the higher seeded girl. They both opened up with doubles, while Josh the winner yesterday, so it was first and third on the weekend. So four really good stories here, wrapping up a really fun weekend to kick off 2022 in the second half of the season. To the shock of absolutely no one, Josh opens up with front three. Elias is the picture book definition of nonplussed. So yesterday, Josh shoots 277 at him to win the title. Today, Caitlin shoots 276 at him. So far, the Abagañas are averaging 276.5 on TV this weekend against Elias. San Diegan on San Diegan violence. Caitlin Sparrows in the third after a double. And stop everything. Clearly, the pin setters thought that Elias threw that ball. Josh did not strike. Josh on some kind of roll, really having a fantastic season. Won the season opener at Forest and just hasn't looked back from there. One of the better shot repeaters on tour. When Madison is on, she is absolutely one of the best girls on tour as well. She'll be battling Caitlin for all conference girl bowler of the year for either. Nice shot there, flat 10 though. Josh, outstanding spare shooter. Up. Couldn't even get it out of my mouth before that dreaded 6-10 chop rears its ugly head again. Yep, Elias getting a little mouthy over there, seeing his big opportunity. See, he better back up his talk right now and keep throwing good shots himself. And he does. All right. Even though we're on a completely different pattern today, house yesterday, scorpion today, it seems to me like they've both developed that same look that they were kind of looking for, where they're getting a little friction in the middle, but also creating some hold in the middle. Earlier today, there was no hold in the middle. If you missed left, it was gone. It seems like they've finally found a way to tame out the pocket area, but as soon as I say that, just a pinch high and the 479 combo rears its ugly head. The 270 to 260 they just had was a complete anomaly. Those are the two highest gains of the day by anyone, by far. Expect a much lower U17 match here, even though they're both bowling well. Maddie gets that hit in the fourth to keep things pretty much even over there. Tampa Bay up 17. Good news is they have a chance at the two seed. The bad news is they might play those slimy, slimy Saints again. Scares the tar out of me. We'll see what happens. Abagaña's up at the same time. Dead flush for Josh, dead flush for Caitlin, but Caitlin rings the 10. Winner makes. In what context, sir?
So, like, say that Caitlin wanted to shoot the spare with the ramp.
Yes.
Yeah, that would be legal.
All your fingers.
Yeah, you put all your fingers in, throw down the ramp. Mm-hmm.
I don't think the ramp would be counted as part of the ball.
Oh, that's fair enough.
You know?
That would be an outside, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it wouldn't be.
Do you know we actually pulled out an old regular metal ramp about 10 years ago for the last shot. We took all the
out.
Let them do like an old man ramp shot. We thought it was hilarious. But we left a couple people out that we didn't know were breaking out. They went to
the dessert. Oh no.
So that was the first and last time we ever did the ramp.
Oh man. I better be using the ramp.
So if you're feeling the ramp when it's time to go, let me know and we'll see if we can bring that back.
Alright, that'll be one last time. Yeah, I'll get my cane.
Yeah.
I'll fetch the ball.
There you go.
Cane,
There you go. That, by the way, was Hunter making sure he got some camera time today. He's not used to going a weekend without some air time here. He wanted to fill in. Pretty shot by Maddie there. She gets a double. Takes a 10-pin lead in that match with that double. Elias hangs in there with that strike. He trails by less than a mark. I can't see that screen at all. Thank you, Elias. We love Mira and we're grateful for all they do for us, but some of those old school AMF monitor colors need to be thought again. Those old AccuScore colors were even worse way back in the day. Anybody watching remembers those. Ah, nice ball from Elias. Ties it up. Maddie unable to increase her lead. We'll have a 310 over there to shoot at. Tour takes a rare week off next week. At least off the road. We'll be finishing up the schedule, among other things. And then goes on to Laughlin, Nevada. Dual conference event. In Salem, Oregon. Before we're back in SoCal at Morongo for Super Bowl weekend, our annual tradition. Josh carries that light hit. Maddie at the always tricky 310.
She got it.
Nicely done. Jacob, come on over here and get you a wall. This way if you don't want to be on camera, this way if you do want to be on camera. Attaboy, there you go. That's what I would have said too. Title number 4, you love this bowling alley. Oh, 3? Well, you love this bowling alley nonetheless.
Hey, Canyon will be 4.
Ah, you calling it out. Wow. Bold words. I like it. It's on now. You got to back that up. You said it.
Yeah.
That's it. Gagne in the 8th. Strike working and there is the crucial error perhaps. Right through the schnoz, the 4-6-7. Caitlin dead even with Maddie right now. Strike working can extend to a 9-pin lead if she can make it 3 in a row. Ooh, almost the same fate as her brother, but breaks up the split into a much more makeable 4-7. Just barely 15 years old, Josh 16, right? So much talent at still such a young age. I feel like they've been bowling forever. Still got plenty of time left. Caitlin, I'm sure, will be highly recruited by just about every school that's got a female team in the world. Oh, hollering! 3 in a row! Good news is he's got a chance at the win. The bad news is U17 pays $25 and he gave away a couple hundred to Team Abagani earlier this week. These guys will play each other over and over and over again all season long and each one is gonna get their share of it, I guarantee you. Uh-oh, game on. Maddie slaps that 5 over into the 7. Keeps that 1-pin lead. But you did win 3 brackets yesterday. You had no business winning whatsoever.
So, oh, my 140.
Yeah.
It's okay. You can thank Zach for that.
Yeah. There you go.
Hunter.
Among others. Hunter made his donation. Yeah. No, it wasn't Hunter. It was.
Don't mean the ladder.
I forget. Oh, Connor, yeah. Madison also, just a wonderful physical game. Both Caitlin and Madison, if you want to teach a young lady, or any bowler, but especially a young lady how to bowl, watch those physical games. Their shoulders are just dead still at the foul line, arm swing going, projected towards their target. Just entirely fun physical games to watch, and a great physical game to emulate. Well, it's falling apart for Josh, and if that's the game you're gonna lose, that would be the one to do. Get over there! Rolls the 5 into the 7, doesn't quite get it. she'll travel a 9 with that conversion. So Josh will wind up with a first yesterday, a third today, and a U17 runner-up today to go with the U17 win yesterday. That ain't so bad for weekend of all. Caitlin, no problem at all with that 7. There's what he's been doing all weekend. Robo Josh from yesterday. Back for one more frame. Anybody's game and girls over here. That ninth frame 310 will make it a little tougher. Losing in the count battle now, no matter if she makes this or not. Oh no. Unable to pick that up, she can now only max to 212. Pullman in the 220s right now, so Maddie's just got to fill frames in order to catch the girl scratch today. Perhaps we're going to spread the wealth a little bit. Josh will finish out in the 180s over there. 180 would have won a lot of matches today. Those scores have been. And it was a minus 140 cut today if you didn't watch the first part. So that's why, but what? Worse than a 175 average. Hard, hard batter. Elias has it all going. Splattered that one. So he's going to come back with, what is that? That's a 230 game. 240 if he gets one more hit. That's pretty good two games of bowling on Scorpion. Pullman will head east back to the homestead in Round Phoenix with the Mazes. Gear up for whatever they got next. And a lot of these parents are going to get a little bit of time off themselves. These parents have had main event, and a lot of them went straight here. A lot of them had a college tournament the week before main event. SYC is coming up. USA Bowling is coming up. I know it's the kids that are on camera all the time, but these parents have been along for the ride, too, and being the ride for these kids, let alone. Doesn't matter, the spare on the ninth was good enough to wrap it up. She will win girls' scratch, she being Maddie Holman. And we're going to wrap up a really fun weekend of action here in San Diego. Surf Bowl, we'll see you soon. And 276 for this young lady to highlight the whole night. We'll see you next time.